Hi guys, my name is Umair and welcome to Umair's workshop. Today I'm going to talk about the W1209 circuit setting, internal settings. I have told you in my previous video how to set up W1209 circuit setting, how to make a circuit to trigger something like fan or bulb in my previous video. If you don't find it, maybe the link should be up showing up here. So here it is a setting, full setting, like from P0 to P6. So first of all, we are going to talk about this P0. P0 means it is for refrigeration or heating, like you want to trigger a fan or a bulb. Like if it is a room where you have to cool it, you are going to use a fan. But if you want to heat up a room, you are going to use a bulb, so it is a P0. So how are you going to use it? See, it is a static button. Press it up until it will show P0. In P0, you are going to press the set button again and it will turn into H. If you are going to press the C plus, it is going to C. So now it is only going to work if the room wants to be cooled, but if you switch it on the heat, so it is going to heat up the room only. So it is a one time thing, like if you want to heat up or you want to cool up, it works in only one at a time, but it can work on both things, but one at a time. So P0 is defined like if you want to heating or refrigeration. And on to the P1, let's go to P1. P1, we have a different setting from this side. If I'm going to show you on how much setting I have set it, it's going back and it is showing 33.3. So switch it up, it is 38.0. So if I want to, when it reaches 38, so when it will turn on, it means this hysteresis setting, like how much difference you want to put it back. So if it reached 38, so on how many difference it will turn on, so you are going to put that in P1. In P1 it is a 0.01.0. So let's switch it up. Maybe I'm going to zoom up here, so maybe you can see it clearly. Maybe not. So here you go. It is P1, and on P1 I'm going to put up a 2.0 difference. Then on when it will turn off at 38, it will turn on 36. So that's how you are going to put a difference. If you are going to put it 35, when it going to turn off at 38, it will turn on 32. So that's how it is going to work. So on P2, what we do have at P2 is maximum setting limit. On how much setting do you want to set? It is factory setting is 1 to 0, like how many maximum limit you can set. Do you want to set on 38? Do you want to set it on 40? Do you want to set it on 50 and don't want to go over it? You have to set it out. So let's see if let's put it on to the like 40 and then see what is going to show. So it is going to going on 40. It's kind of really slow. Anyway, we are at 40 now. I have set it on to P2 on 40 and let's see what are we going to see in when we are going to set it out in the temperature setting system. So it is 33 right now. Let's try out if we can go on over the 40. See, it's stuck on 40. It is not going behind that 40 because we have set it maximum setting up to 40. It cannot be set over it. So that's the same thing if we are going to P3. At P3 it is minus 50. The maximum lowest setting is 50. Let's trying to minus, yes, I am going to minus it up, but it is getting over it. So like if I want to make it under, if I want to not let it go under 20, like we are going to see it is 20. Okay, so I have put it 20 in P3, and let's see if we go back, can we go? But we can't because we have set it internal setting to 20. So if someone behind you trying to push that buttons and took it to the very lowest, he can only go to the 20, not. So it is stuck in 20. Alright, so on to the P3 we have covered, and temperature correction P4. Let's go to the P4 and see what do we have here. In P4 we have temperature correction of 000. We are not getting what? Alright, so let's go to set it again on 38 and go back to P4 to see what happened. Let's go. To trigger the P4, maybe I have to make it P3 on minus 50 again. So then we can set on P4 because it is showing minus 7, and let's see what we do. So we are going back on P3 to make it again on 50. On the factory reset setting, then we are going to P4. So this is the maximum factory setting. So P4 we have 002. Like it is showing right now, it is showing this. See, it is showing 34.9 and it is showing 33.9, it is going 34.9. So if it is being accurate, it is accurate. So if I want to change it is temperature correction, we are going to go and P4, and I'm going to put it like, hey, 9 degrees difference I'm getting. So it is going to convert that into showing temperature right now. So it should be showing more than that. See, it was showing 34, now it is 34.6. so let's do it again so we can come up with that temperature of the same. Like if it is the same and you trust on this, both this is the most accurate, but if you trust on other like room temperature or more, and let's see, I have put it into the correction of 34.9 by that correction time. So let's put it back 34.9 to, we don't want any correction, so put it at 0. Now it is going to show actual reading it is showing, but if you want to change it, you can change it by P4. So let's go to P5. At P5 what do we have is, like, suppose you have you want to uh, when you turn it on and you want to delay its starting time, you go to P5 and like 3 second delay, like any kind of number is cancelled you want, and then you put a 3 second delay. So next time when you are going to turn it back on, it's going to take around like, so for if I turn it back on like next time, it will delay about like 3 seconds. So let's see if it can be set upon it. I'm going to take it out and put it back on. So I've took it back on. See, this is a 333 is going to show. Then it is going to, after 3 seconds, sorry, let's put it back on. I've turned it off. Then when I'm going to turn it on back, it is getting like, should be set it about like P5. Let's put it 6-8 second difference timing, and let's see if it is going to work. So when I'm going to turn it back on, it's not working, I don't know why, but it should be like extending the time of starting time from 0 second to 10 minutes. And what do we have here? It's at P6 we have a high temperature alarm. Okay, so we have high temperature alarm from 1001 to 10 or booting. Alright, so if we are going to go into the P6, let's see what we have in P6. In P6 we have off. What do we have off? Yeah, we have off 16. Let's put it into on. So what is on? I don't know. So okay, so it is on and off only, and go back and see what if it has, maybe P8, and what it will have. It have P7 and P8, but it is not mentioned. What do we have here? We have tried all together from that. So anyway, in P7, P6, we have turned the high temperature alarm to on. But this circuit doesn't have any buzzer or alarm to turn on if it goes over it is high temperature. Alright, maybe in the P7 check it out, nothing, and P8 nothing, like yeah, it is showing something but I don't know what it is at P8. So let's go it. So that's how it's going to work. It is a full and complete and detailed specification of W1209. I have shown you everything. Two things are not working in it is these two things and other things. Anyway, if you are going to making it for incubator or any kind of cooler, only two of these settings are used. Not to go on these settings, they are useless for these kind of experiments. So if you like this video, like, subscribe, share, and thank you. Bye bye, take care.